Even 6 months back, if you'd have told me that I'll be able to build an automated video editing application on my own using AI, I wouldn't have believed you. But that is exactly what I've done. And what you see here is a video editing application that I built using AI. And for building this, I used a combination of Tempo Labs and Cursor. So let me give you a quick demo of how this application works. I'll just upload a video. I'm going to upload this video. And this pop-up comes up, it analyzes the video, transcribes the video, detects silence, and analyzing content is basically it's detecting bad takes in the video, and this is how the interface looks. And straight away, you'll probably notice some kind of inspirations from something like Gling.ai and Descript, but I really wanted to build this specifically because I wanted to edit my videos quickly, and this was a way to do it, and I wanted to build that application myself. Now, the fact is that I was not at all confident when I started because I tried to do this using Cursor, I tried to do this using Bolt and many other softwares, and none of it worked. In fact, I tried to do this using Cursor twice or thrice earlier, but I was not able to get the basics right. I'll come to that later on. So let's have a look at the app itself. This is a section where I'll probably remove this later on. I'll probably add some other buttons to this one. These values are already set in the code, which means that whatever you see as default is in here. Now we can adjust it, but it's not necessary. We are getting really good output from this itself. Then in the middle, we have something called transcript editor. So this is the transcript of the video. And you can see certain things here. I'll come to that. On the right side, we have the video player. And at the bottom, we have the timeline. In the timeline, you can see that this section is actually a little darker blue compared to these sections, because those sections are a combination of silences and bad take detection. Okay. And in the transcript editor, what you see as strike through, they are basically bad takes. Okay. So if you see here, oh man, I'm just so happy. Okay, so that line, I abandoned it and I started over again. Oh man, I'm so happy I finally implemented this. Now, this is not exactly the same line, but it feels more or less the same thing. And yet the app was able to figure that out. And the third time around, I repeat the same thing. Oh man, I'm just so happy that I finally added that one feature I wanted to. Okay, so it figured out that this is the line which has a proper flow and it is going forward properly. So it literally removed everything before that. Anything that has this starting, it has removed that. So you can see that those bad takes has been removed. Okay. It has also done really well with the silence detection. This is a silence section. This is a silence section. So some of these things are also silence. The waveform needs to be improved, and then I'm working on that. And here you can see there are two options, show cuts and skip cuts. If I click on skip cuts, what will happen? If I play this video, it will literally start from here. Okay, it will skip this whole section. And now if I export this video, it will only export the sections that are not cut, meaning this anything that is in the dark blue section will not be rendered. Okay, so what you'll see here is that we're not losing any information. This is as if it is there. We're not cutting it out. It's just being skipped. Okay, and as I play, you can see here, word by word, you get highlighting. So that is perfectly matched to the timing of the video. And let's say I don't like the cuts, automatic cuts, and I want to make some manual cuts as well. Let's say I don't want this whole line, or let's say just this much. Okay. I'm going to select that section and you get a pop-up called cut. I'm going to cut it and that will be cut. And you probably noticed earlier, if I'm selecting some section here, you can see that selection here in a different color, which is a yellow color. So if I cut, that section will be cut off. So this also acts more like a docs editor than a video editor. So it's easy for newbies to edit. And it's not like it just has the docs-like editing options, but it also has proper editing options as well. And that is in the timeline. So if I go and select this section and come to the end here, I can click and drag it wherever I want. I can adjust that cut point to wherever I want. But at the same time, if I want to add a cut here, I can bring the playhead here. Okay, I'll keep it here and then click on this button, and that adds a cut or a split wherever I keep my playhead at. So it's a heavily featured app, and I'm actually very, very happy and proud of how it has turned out. And I still cannot believe that I was able to build something like this. And let me show you the process. So I'll go to the project in Tempo Labs. So like I said, I have tried it with other softwares, but it was not working out. Even with Tempo, so it was actually Shivratri and I had thought that I was not going to sleep. So I had enough time. So this is, like you can see, long list of prompts in Tempo Labs itself. So I'll show you how I got started. I started it specifically telling it simple. It was a very simple prompt. I just told it, give me an AI powered automatic video editing app. Okay, so it started creating these, generating the PRDs and this user flow. If I just look at this one, straight away I saw a problem. So it was trying to build a landing page and then the whole thing after that. So I told it exactly that, and we can think about the landing page later on. First, let us build a functioning app. So the thing about Tempo is that the first prompt, whatever you give it, it's not functional. Generally speaking, in my experience, the result that you get from the first prompt is just the design. So this is what it was. So then I told it to make it functional, and it actually came back with something that was better than anything else that I had tried so far. So this is how it looked. And this was the very first iteration. So we had something more like header, which is video editor, save project, export project, then the video player here, and a weird timeline with these slider controls. But the moment I saw the timeline, I was like, okay, we are onto something, because none of the other products could do that much. Okay, so this gave me a lot of hope. So I was like, okay, fine. Now let me clearly give it instructions on how I want it to look. So before going into any functions, I gave it clear instructions on how I want the app to look. And once that was set, I was like, okay, I kept on iterating with it. And it was Tempo which came up with, like, I was initially thinking I'll be needing to use AI with a lot of APIs and all sorts of things. That's what I thought. Out of nowhere, when I was not expecting anything at all, Tempo gave me a result which detected the silence straight away. I was like, oh my God, that's great. It was using some kind of machine learning to detect the silence. And so I went forward and I got to a point like this one. If I play here, this is what we got to. In fact, we got to a much better state. So this is what we had. We had these things, the colors were not set. The timeline was a little bit, the height was a little more. There was an export button here, which I didn't like. The player was here. And this whole section, obviously, I hadn't connected it to something like DeepGram for transcript either. The base of the product I got from here, like I said, this, look at this. The silence detection was happening perfectly. So this is where I was like, okay, fine, I can push it. I can push it to a different level. But what happened after that was it started to hallucinate at one point in time, and there was an issue. It just couldn't solve it. It just, I gave it like 7-8 prompts after that. I was like, okay, fine, now this is getting annoying. And so I tried to restore it, and where I wanted to restore it to, it was not happening. There was some kind of issue there. I never did this, but this was the first time I tried to do this. What I did was I got to a point where I was like, okay, this is a safe code. Nothing has been lost. I can take this out if I can, because I didn't know I could do that. So I clicked on this button here, the Git settings, and I literally exported the code to GitHub. So then I went into Cursor and then opened the repo in Cursor. And I was able to run it here very easily, because like I said, I had tried to do this in Cursor before. 2 to 3 times I had tried to create this project, but every time there was a lot of things that I had to run, and it would just reach a point where nothing was going forward. But this time around, it worked out. It straight away, when I opened the repo, it was a very easy process, and it just, I could run it. Okay. Now I was like, okay, now I have a functioning app here. Let me add specific features that I want. Okay. So what happened was it went from this, how it looked here. I added a header and I added this whole section of transcript editor. And finally, this is how the editor looked. It's not just the way it looks, the functionings, all of it had to be worked on. Okay, so the ability to cut, to adjust the clips. So if I want to move this around like this, I'm able to do that now, but it wasn't. I had to add that in cursor. This whole section had to be added here. A lot of things actually, even design wise, it changed. I got a great start from Tempo and then I was able to take it to cursor. And this is where I am right now. And I'm so happy with the output, to be frank. But there are things that I want to add to this. I'm not like, okay, fine, let me rest on this. There are a few things. There is a limit to the file size right now, which I want to remove. And quite a bit of time went into fixing the export function itself so that when an export is done, only the sections that are not cut comes out. And that cut section is not there in the video. And at one point in time, it was also giving the other way around. So it was only giving the cut portion and I kept prompting. I remember I probably tried to do that for 2 hours and finally it was done. I was like, oh my God, thank God. So this was a project that I learned so much from. Like I said, the video that I created yesterday, this was a project that gave me confidence to tell myself, okay, let me modularize my flowchart app and then bring it to cursor, because I was always scared of cursor. Like cursor, every time I tried doing something with it, it always annoyed me. This project let me have confidence in working with cursor. So after this, I created another app and then I created another app. So 2 more projects has been done using this. And one is like really large. It's not complete, but I'm very, very excited about that as well, which is, I don't know if I want to sell it as a SaaS or anything like that, even this. I actually developed it specifically for my own purposes, but this looks great, I think. So maybe, I don't know, later on, if I can add some extra features that makes it stand out, I'd probably want to maybe sell it as a SaaS. So that is it for this video. Let me know in the comment section what you think about this project. And if you want to watch other AI related content, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next one.